the man who saved baseball in Los Angeles, Magic Johnson. How are you?
I'm doing great. You know, just happy to have a night and celebrate the Dodgers and the ownership of the Dodgers.
What's when you first realized that it was on sale, the Dodgers were on sale, what was your first reaction to it?
Well, first I was in disbelief because teams and organizations like the Dodgers very rarely come up on the market, especially with the Dodger pride and the brand as strong as the Dodger brand is. And so when I start interviewing different groups and trying to decide who I was going to go with, that was a long process. But once I settled in on the Guggenheim baseball partners, that group, Mark Walter, Stan Castan, and myself, I thought we had a great chance of winning. Didn't know if we would win, but I thought we had a good chance.
Since you took over, you guys are number one right now. That's a great stat.
Yeah, it's a great stat that we're in first place. We have the best record in baseball. That's what it's all about. The guys have responded, you know.
Did you go in there and give them a pep talk?
No, nothing we've done. We had great players already. Clayton Kershaw won the Cy Young last year. Matt Kemp could have been the MVP. Andre Ethier is playing great this season. So we have a lot of great young players, and we want to keep those young players together. But I think that they just felt good that they now know they have a good ownership group. And the benefit is they're great play, and now all Dodger fans can feel good about their team being back and can feel good, hopefully, about us.
Well, it definitely feels good. Well, I read that as a little sign of a gesture to all the players, you actually gave them a Magic Johnson jersey signed?
Yeah, I gave them a couple of jerseys.
That's amazing.
One for them and one to give away to their favorite charity, because we should always be about giving back.
Speaking about giving back, you got the Magic Johnson Foundation. Arsenio Hall just won $250,000 off the Celebrity Apprentice. What did you guys do with that money? Where is that going to?
It's going to go to education. We have 150 students on scholarship, and then we, with the money, we're going to add between another 35 to 50 students. So it's great.
You're always giving back, and I think that's amazing. It's something that you're jumping into right now is on the telecommunication side is Aspire.
Right. Aspire, we're going to launch it June 27th. It'd be the third African-American channel. I'm excited about that. And, we always want to continue to touch the community in a positive way, and that's what I've always been about and will continue to be about.
What kind of content can we be expecting from Aspire?
Well, I think, you know, when you think about it, we will have family content in terms of we did our poll, we did our research and homework, and what they want is some content that is screwed toward family and the African-American professional as well. So we're going to do that, and we're excited.
You're a very disciplined person when it comes to business, very business savvy. I was doing some research. Your secret language name, actually, is a disciplined mortal mirror. And you just reflect amazingness all around, and we wish you all the best. I actually wanted to gift you this book. Have you ever heard of this book, The Secret Language of Birthdays?
I hadn't heard of it, but I'm going to definitely read it because you gave it to me.
It'll tell you all about your personality. I was doing some research on it, and, you know, it'll tell you all your characteristics and strength. Really, from what I read there, it describes you to a T. It's absolutely amazing, and you're very inspirational to everyone else. So we wanted to thank you very much for saving baseball for us and being an incredible person who's giving back to the community at all times.
Well, thank you for this incredible gift. You know, I love knowledge. I love to learn, so I look forward to reading it, okay? Hey, secretlanguage.tv, this is the Magic Man.